Yo, what is going on, guys? And it's your boy RRB Plays here today, bringing you guys yet another beastly insane FIFA 21 squad builder to the channel. And in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the best 200k team built around the new release player of the month, Ansu Fati. Yes, that's right, guys. So this video is for you guys that have already done this SBC card and are looking for a relatively cheap team to build around him. So as I just said, I'm going to be showing you guys an insane 200k team built around Ansu Fati. But before I go ahead and dive into this insane squad builder, I got a quick little message for you guys, so let me get straight into it. So if you guys want me to build you your own personal squad builder, yes, that's right, guys, you heard correctly. If you want me to build you your own personal squad builder, all you guys have to do is simply follow a few quick and easy steps. All you guys have to do is simply like the video, subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications. And once you've done that, take a picture, screenshot that, head over to my Instagram, follow my Instagram and a DM me that screenshot of you following the steps. It's literally that easy, it's literally that simple, so make sure you guys go ahead and do that if you want me to build your own personal squad, and then you can end up like these guys. So it's literally that simple, so make sure you follow the steps if you want me to build your own personal squad builder. But enough of the chit chat, I hope you guys do end up enjoying this video and remember to follow the steps, alright guys? But yeah, literally this team will destroy your opponents in Foot Champions and in Division Rivals. So without further ado, let's waste no more time and get straight into the squad builder, baby. Let's get it, let's go. Okay guys, so as you can see on your screens right now, for this insane 200k hybrid, the formation that you guys want to use is the 4-3-3-4 variation, alright? But you can use this formation if you want to, but at the end of the video, once I've shown you guys a team, I'll also show you another formation that you can use with this team. But with that being said, let's waste no more time and actually just jump into the first player of this incredible squad builder. So in the striker position, we do have a man that everyone loves to use nowadays in this stage of FIFA, and he goes by the name of Rodrigo, man. This cheap, sweaty, overpowered beast himself. Well, I mean, he's not really that cheap, but he kind of is, he kind of isn't, I don't know. But yeah, he costs around 30k. Rodrigo, absolutely insane in this game, bros. 4-star skill moves. Yes, I know he's only got the 3-star weak foot, but he's finishing, and like he just seems like a meta player to use at this stage of FIFA. You know, he's got the pace about him and he's a very, very clinical striker as well. I know it only says 80 finishing in there, but I think everyone that has used Rodrigo in this game will know that he's got very, very good finishing, and he's just one of those clinical starter strikers for you guys to use. So I do recommend you guys go ahead and pick up Rodrigo, because I'm telling you, man, he's going to get you plenty of goals in that striker position, man. He really is overpowered in this game. But moving on in towards the right wing spot we go, we actually do have the Arsenal man himself, the Arsenal right winger, Nicola Pepe. Nicola Pepe, very overpowered in this game. He's got the pace about him, he's got the skill moves about him. He just genuinely fits the meta of this game, in my opinion, and I really do like him cutting in from that right hand side. Yes, he does have 2-star weak foot, but he does have 4-star skill moves. And also, again, you don't really notice a 2-star weak foot that much, because most of the time you will be cutting inside and shooting on his stronger left foot. But with that being said, as you guys can see, he's got 90 sprint speed and 88 acceleration, 77 finishing and 80 shot power, 89 agility, 81 ball control and 85 dribbling. He is an overpowered card in this game and very effective off that right-hand side. And like I said, cutting in, finessing it far post will just work really, really well with Nicola Pepe. So make sure you guys do that with him, because that's basically how you're going to use him to his strength and to his the way he should be used. But moving on though, in the cam spot we actually do have a striker, but I put him here, like I said, for chemistry reasons and all that good stuff. So like I said, if you don't want to play him cam, then I'll show you what formation to switch to in game. But we actually do have Richarlison, man. Richarlison is just a beast and I just love this guy, man. Honestly, a couple days ago I made a team with him, I played some games with him, and I really, really enjoyed using him, man. He is so effective in this game. He's got 5-star weak foot, he's got 4-star skill moves. There's just nothing you can really compare complain about when it comes to using Richarlison, bros, because he is just almost the perfect player. Yeah, 4-star skill moves, 5-star weak foot. He's so unpredictable. Defenders never know what foot you want to shoot on because of the 5-star weak foot. His dribbling and ball control is very good. His finishing is exceptional, and he's got a decent pace about him as well. So, yeah, Richarlison is an incredible player, and I highly, highly, highly do recommend that you guys go ahead and pick up Richarlison because he is just incredible. But moving on in towards the right centre mid spot, we actually do have a very nice right centre mid, box-to-box kind of midfielder. He goes by the name of Fred, and I really do like Fred in this game. He reminds me a little bit like Kante, but just like he can attack basically, which Kante isn't really the best at doing. Like, Fred literally just reminds me of Kante, but a Kante that's actually good going forward. It's crazy because I just think he's so effective. I think he's so overpowered. He's just so small, quick, nimble, agile, and just like a little rat running around the midfield, just hunting everyone down. It's just crazy, man. I think he's so effective in this game. He's got 79 sprint speed and 79 acceleration. He does have 4-star skill moves and a 4-star weak foot as well, which is very, very nice to have, especially from a centre mid slash CDM. Yeah, very good defending stats as well, very good dribbling stats. And again, there's just not much you can complain about Fred because he's just so good in this game, so well rounded, and that is what I do like about him. So make sure you guys go ahead and pick up Fred. He will get you a very good job done in that midfield spot. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, in the left centre mid spot to partner up with Fred, we do have Fernando, and he is slightly more of a defensive-minded midfielder, someone that's going to be picking up the ball, winning it back, laying it off to the likes of Fred and Richarlison and so on. But he's very cheap, very effective though, and again, like I said, he's the anchor of the team. He's the one that's going to be winning you the ball back, and just he's just got very, very good at defending stats. So as you guys can see here, Fernando, pretty decent player, like I said, good defending stats, 85 interceptions, 83 defensive awareness, 83 standing tackle, and 81 at slide tackle. Yes, I know he's not the fastest, but I don't feel like the pace is much needed for the way you're meant to play with Fernando, if you get what I'm saying, because he's going to be in that CDM spot. He doesn't need to cover much ground. All he just needs to do really is just defend very, very well. So yeah, that's his job. A little bit, he's like basically a cheap version of Casemiro. That's literally what Fernando is like, a cheaper Casemiro. So yeah, make sure you guys go ahead and pick him up. But that does complete the midfield and attack. Let's move on in towards the defense. And in the right back spot, we do have one of my favorite fullbacks in the game, bros. He goes by the name of Yedlin. Absolutely incredible in this game. Love him to bits. Just so pacey, sweaty, and just a pain. Such a pain to play against, bros. Honestly, I love him. I love him. Like, honestly, I love this guy because, yeah, I use him in all of my cheap squads where I can fit him in. And he's just so effective. He really is just so effective. So pacey and just decent at defending. Again, he's just your typical starter, fullback that you want to use. So yeah, make sure you guys go ahead and pick up Yedlin. Not too much to say about him apart from the fact that he's literally the Flash, all right? He's the Flash that can defend. That's what he is, bro. So rapid. But in the left back spot, we do have yet another Brazilian in the squad builder, and he goes by the name of Renan Lodi. Yeah, Renan Lodi, very effective in this game, not as fast as Yedlin, but still very much usable in the game. Got a decent amount of pace and good at defending as well, good ball control, good agility and so on, 4-star skill moves as well. Yeah, there's not too much bad things to say about Renan Lodi. He gets his job done, he does what he needs to do. So I recommend you guys go ahead and pick up Renan Lodi. But with that being said, let's move on in towards the centre back partnership. And now, guys, in the right centre back spot, we do have another Manchester United player. He goes by the name of Eric Bailly. A very overpowered card in this game, extremely highly rated by a lot of people in this game. I think he's so effective, very strong, got a decent amount of pace to him as well, good defending stats. Again, you just simply cannot go wrong. As you guys can see, 85 strength, 85 aggression, 80 standing tackle, 81 sliding tackle. He is just such a good card, and that does go for the same as the man who will be partnered up with Eric Bailly in the center back spot, Diego Carlos, bros. Diego Carlos, I love this guy to bits, man. Again, another beastly defender that we do have in this team, bros. And again, he's just a cheap beast. He really is a cheap beast. And I've accidentally picked Carlos Vela. Where the hell is Diego Carlos, bros? Where is he? Diego Carlos. Come on, come on, come on. There we go, Diego Carlos. But yeah, as I was saying, very effective. Again, another pacey centre-back, man. This duo, they work so well together because they're both pretty fast and they're both very, very good at defending. They actually are very, very similar in this game, to be honest. But yeah, Diego Carlos has 84 interceptions, as you guys can see there. 83 defensive awareness, 82 standing tackle, and 81 slide tackle. 86 strength and 85 aggression also. So yeah, a very effective centre-back to use in this game. So make sure you guys go ahead and pick him up. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, in the goalkeeper position, we do have David De Gea, man. David De Gea, very overpowered in this game and should make you a lot of good saves. So yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say really about a goalkeeper. There's only so much I can say. It's not like they really have a certain way or certain style of playing. But yeah, David De Gea should make you a lot of good saves, and I think he's very, very effective to use, and I think that he'll just, yeah, make you a lot of saves, as I just said. But with that being said, as you guys can see on your screens right now, this is the insane 200k team around Fatty. Remember guys, it's around Fatty, which basically means that it's all the tradable players that add up to 200k, all right? Fatty's SBC price is not included in the squad because he's an untradeable SBC card. But with that being said, I'm going to show you guys another formation that you guys can use in game with this incredible team. So the formation that you guys can actually use is actually the 4-2-2, and I actually really do rate this formation highly. It's a formation which I'm currently using, and I really, really do enjoy it. I just, for some reason, it just seems to work well this FIFA. And yeah, so basically, if you do switch this formation in game, this is how you want to set up: Rodrigo left striker, Richarlison right striker, Nicolas Pepe right cam, Fred and Fernando's the two DMs. You can actually swap these two around because Fred is left footed and I'm pretty sure Fernando is right footed. Yeah, so make sure Fred is the left DM, and then Ansu Fati in left cam, and then the defensive lineup will stay the same. So that's literally how you guys want to set up in game. Yeah, it's literally that simple. You guys should start destroying your opponents once you use this team, but let me know how you find it after playing some games with this team, man. I want to know what your thoughts are, because I really do think the team is overpowered and I really do think you can get a lot of wins with this team. But with that being said, I hope you did enjoy the video. Make sure you do smash the like button because it is much appreciated, and also guys, subscribe and turn on post notifications if you guys do enjoy the video. And also yeah, sorry for no gameplay today. It's just because Ansu Fati really isn't a card that I can actually afford myself right now, to be honest, unless I'm literally trying to have Ansu Fati with a bunch of bronze players. But yeah, make sure you guys go ahead and pick up this team. Absolutely insane. And I hope you did enjoy the video. It's been your boy RB Plays, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out, baby.